Good afternoon. Welcome to the Church of St. Mary. We welcome all visitors and members of this area faith community. God has gathered us together to renew our efforts in sharing the life of Christ and being the love of Christ. Let us stand and introduce ourselves to those we know and greet the presence of Christ in one another. Our gathering song this afternoon is number 209, or on the screens, Holy, Holy, Holy.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Gathered here today in this time, we come to the Lord's table, that we might be nourished, forgiven, and indeed graced by the God of life, mindful of those times when we have experienced the sin of greed, as we hear in today's gospel. Let us ask the Lord our God to grant to us his forgiveness, his pardon, and mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are the Prince of Peace. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Lord of all. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. Son, Lord God, Lamb of God. take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their Creator and Guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Vanity of vanities, says Koheleth. Vanity of vanities, all things are vanity. Here is one who has labored with wisdom and knowledge and skill. And yet to another who has not labored over it, he must leave his property. This also is vanity and a great misfortune. For what profit comes to man from all the toil and anxiety of heart with which he has labored under the sun? All his days, sorrow and grief is his occupation. Even at night, his mind is not at rest. This also is vanity. The word of the Lord.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The Lord's rule is to be trusted, the simple find wisdom. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The fear of the Lord is holy, the abiding forever. The decrees of the Lord are true, all of them just. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The precepts of the Lord are right, they gladden the heart. The commands of the Lord is clear, giving light to the eye. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. They are worth more than gold, than the finest gold, sweeter than honey from the comb. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Sisters and brothers, if you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. Put to death, then, the parts of you that are earthly: immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and the greed that is idolatry. Stop lying to one another, since you have taken off the old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed for knowledge in the image of its creator. Here there is not Greek and Jew, circumcision and uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, but Christ is all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. Alleluia. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." Jesus replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbitrator?" Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." Then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest. He asked himself, "What shall I do, for I do not have space to store my harvest?" And he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods, and I shall then say to myself, 'Now as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, be merry.'" But God said to him, "You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong? Thus it will be for all who store up treasure for themselves, but are not rich in what matters to God." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, hopefully everybody here tonight has had the opportunity to answer the question that we all saw on the screens before Mass. It was a simple question with an image. The question was, "How big is your barn?" Did you answer the question for yourself? Did you take out a tape measure? Did you figure out the square footage? How large is your barn? It's a good question. A question that is at the heart of today's gospel, but actually at the very heart of today's gospel, we have another question. Actually, it's a statement at the very end of the Luke's gospel, and the statement is, it's about what matters to God. That's at the heart of today's gospel. But in order to figure out what matters to God, we have to first ask ourselves, well, what really matters to you and I? What is it that is truly important? And we just need reality television shows like American Pickers and Hoarding and Storage Wars to remind you and I that today's gospel still has a place in our society and culture today. Because you and I, as people in this society, we love to collect. We love to gather. We love to store. We love to stockpile. We just simply like to keep stuff. It's true, isn't it? We only need to look at this desire of ours to build a bigger garage, to get another shed, to rent out another storage unit. Why people like you and I do this, not because we have this intent to be greedy. It's not what drives us, although for some people it's a sickness, as we can watch on television. It's an addiction, it's an obsession, as people begin to hoard stuff. But for most people like you and I, why, this need to continually gather and to continually to get more stuff and to have to get more sheds and more storage to hold it all in, it's simply happens because you and I are busy living. And in the course of living, why, we buy stuff, and then we buy more stuff. And then, of course, there's the stuff that we bought years ago that we haven't used for years, but we forget we got the stuff because it's sitting in a storage shed somewhere. It's the madness, it's the craziness that is our lives. It just is who we are. So we don't need to beat ourselves up today. We don't need to leave with even more Catholic guilt than what we came into church with. I don't recommend any of that at all. It's never served us very well up to this point. It probably won't help us anymore. But we have to be mindful that that is oftentimes what it seems to the outsider looking in at our lives, that that seems to be what really matters. What really matters is that we try to get all this stuff, and of course we do it because, of course, we're convinced that someday we're going to need it. And if we don't need it, well, then our kids will. We've convinced ourselves of that. That's why we keep storing up things. That's why we build bigger barns, more sheds, larger garages. Because we're convinced it's insurance. It's another form of life insurance. Because after all, life insurance is important. You and I, why, we've taken the opportunity to invest in it. There are many different types of life insurance. There's the policies that you and I take out that guarantees that upon our death, why, it will pay a certain amount of money to our to those who we've left behind to make sure that they are cared for, and life insurance is incredibly important. But there are other forms of life insurance besides those policies we sign that generate money once we die. Why, again, there's that life insurance of those things that we keep stockpiling and gathering together. But an elderly man once told me this wisdom: self-giving. Self-giving is the best form of life insurance. Self-giving is the best form of life insurance. Because you see, the danger with understanding life insurance like you and I understand it is we're trying to understand life insurance as that which is left to our heirs. But Jesus wants you and I to have life insurance now. He wants you and I to have life and to have it to the full. And it doesn't happen by having more stuff, by collecting more things, by growing rich in the material things of this world, as important and as valuable as they are. Because getting back to the heart of today's gospel, what matters to God is you and I. What matters to God are relationships. What matters to God is the fact that you and I might continually, each and every day, grow in love for Him and for one another. So we have to figure out how to do that, because that's what matters. So it's going to mean that we have to have room in our barns, in our houses, in our vessels. We gotta stop stockpiling resentments, and we have to stop collecting those things that get in the way of relationships experiencing forgiveness and life and love and growth. Because we can stockpile more than just things, my friends. It's those resentments, it's those bitterness that we have maybe towards one another. We can busy collect those as well, and we need to get bigger barns, i.e. in our minds, to house all of that. But Jesus invites you and I to take care to guard against greed in all its forms. And the only way we do that is to keep our eyes focused on what matters to God. Because that, my friends, is what should matter to you and I. It's relationships, it's people, it's family, it's friends, it's the stranger, it's the one who is suffering, it's those who are going without because they don't have the means to make ends meet. It's the people around us and among us and with us. Those are the relationships that need our attention, that need our life. And when we give ourselves to one another, why then, you and I, we have the best life insurance ever. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us come to the Lord in this time of need, as we offer in petition and prayer the needs of this church.
For the church, that we guard against greed and share our gifts with one another, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders who will put the welfare of others before personal gain, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle for balance with work, family, recreation, and prayer, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who never get ahead, who struggle to survive, who don't have enough, that through God's love and our care, their basic needs are met. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died and for those who mourn their loss, remembering today Dell and Wayne Zimmerman and the Henrietta Magus family, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer with illness, addiction, or loneliness, that they experience healing, hope, and our prayers, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of all life, source of our joy, we give you thanks for the gift of your Son, who has taught us how to live, how to give of ourselves to one another. Hear us as we gather in prayer Be attentive to our many prayers. Answer them according to your will. For we ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
But invite our children to bring their offerings forward.
Our song for the preparation of the gifts is number 490, and on the screens, We Walk by Faith.
We walk by faith and not by sight, no gracious words we hear of him who spoke. None e'er spoke, and we believe him near. We may not touch his hands and side, nor follow where he trod, yet in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith abound to call on you when you are near and seek where you are found. That when our life of faith is done in realms of clearer, we may behold you as you are in full and endless light. We walk by faith and not by sight, no gracious words we hear of him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, so will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. In you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again,
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread and this saving cup and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, with all the clergy and all your people. Remember also our sisters and our brothers who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us now pray for the coming of God's kingdom, as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom,
our Lord,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let us share the gift of peace with one another. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 586, and on the screens, "We Are Many Parts." We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. God of all, we look to you. We would be your servants true. Let us be your love to all the world. We are many parts.
and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. So my pain is pain for you, in your joy is my joy too. All is brought together in the world. We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. All you seekers, great and small, seek the greatest gift of all. If you love, then you will know the Lord. We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear.
Our second communion song is number 330, and on the screens, This Bread That We Share, number 330.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Our sending forth song is number 636, and on the screens. Lead me, Lord.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord. For God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled. And the meek shall come to lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are the merciful, for mercy shall be theirs, and the pure in heart shall see their God. Blessed are they whose hunger only holiness shall fill, for I say they shall be satisfied. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are they who through their lifetime sow the seeds of peace. All will call them children of the Lord. Blessed are you, though persecuted in your holy life, for in heaven great is your lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my